bit of swamp shearing here, and then I'm going to go out and finish the rest of the road and put in the landing at the very end. And so this is how I'm going to spend my day and watch the snow and enjoy talking to a few friends while I'm working. Thank you. just doing a little leveling here, but there is no frost underneath this. I just put this in a couple days ago, and it didn't get stiffened up at all. If you notice the ribbons, the Sappy Forester flagged this in, this trail here, and tried to route it through the smaller trees, and he said take out what you need to get your road to work. Yeah, you want to talk about multitasking? Try and run a dozer and fly a drone. You can kind of see it's kind of difficult for me. Have to pause and run a blade and then reach down and fly the drone, and yeah, it's difficult. I was on the phone with Wyatt Hooper, and he had to go out last night or Friday night, I think it was, and pull out that bobcat down there. He dropped it right in through 8 inches of ice and a bunch of muck. I got a call from my son yesterday morning and chewing me out for getting my bobcat sunk. And actually, it was this picture that Wyatt sent. "Your dad buried his bobcat," he goes.
Well, kind of fell in. It wasn't too bad until I tried to put some sticks underneath it. I bent a ram my door. Hopefully I can straighten that out.
Well, my plans are for tomorrow is take the Bobcat back out there where I got it stuck and try and drive around that area, get around because we busted up pretty good with the D6 high drive. They're getting that Bobcat out and finish mowing that. And it's quite a hill. It's almost like a peaked roof. So I'm probably going to encircle that whole island to get a zone on the bottom on the swamp so the skidders can run off the swamp down the hill and have a safety area or be able to get out without burying a skidder.
nice hand holds here, so I don't slip and fall.